can't with a laser focus on making sure that black businesses in the Bayview would have a fair opportunity to access construction contracts at the airport and along 3rd Street, the light rail being built out, as well as the rebuilding of the Bayview Library. And we have to recognize that not for the Bayview's voice, we wouldn't have made the progress that we have made. So here to say that 40 years is just the beginning, and as we recognize in the Jewish tradition, Ad Mayit Esrim, should you live to 120, as did Moses. So if you could, I'd like to present, and I'm so pleased to be here with Supervisor Jane Kim as well. Do you want to come up, Jane? And you can... Do we have other elected officials in the House?
Jeff Adachi.
Jeff Adachi is there as well. I didn't see Jeff. There he is. So, Willie, we couldn't do it without you. And I think of this newspaper as the city's social conscience and moral compass. You keep us on the right track. Congratulations.
No slavery.
I come up as landowners, and not afraid to fight. So living, you have to fight. You have to come together, and that's what we've been able to do. And I'm glad to see people like Jane Kim and our senator here, really sticking their neck out there to help us. And what we need to do is come together. Tell you the truth, I just love fighting pandas. It's time for us to do something now. Yeah. Right now, with the light rail, I mean the high speed rail, mm-hmm. all coming this way,
yep.
it's right here for us. Yep. And if we don't get together and get it, it's our own fault. Mm-hmm. I want to thank people for coming out. And I want everybody to get involved. Right. It's time to be involved. Mm-hmm. We got the best opportunity we ever had. Right now, they even let us put our own money together. Most people you mentioned still are, but that ain't nothing. What do you mean? When did they ever let you put your money together? Or do anything? So let's use what's out there to make sure that people know about it. A whole lot of people don't know now that you can organize and like the people do that have money. You can do both. So let's get together. It's our time to move. Thank you.
All right.
Hi there. My name is Jeff Adachi. I serve as the Public Defender Jeff. I just wanted to come here today and express our sincere gratitude for Willie and Mary and all the incredible work that they've done over the years. Whenever I come to them with an idea, crazy or not, they've always supported it. We wanted to start the Clean Slate program in the Bayview and provide relief for individuals who had suffered criminal convictions and provide expungement services. It was Mary and Willie that I went to first. We opened up the center at the Southeast Community Center. I'm happy to say that after 15 years of still going, we have cleared over 20,000 records. Wow. We started the Be Magic program because we wanted to improve outcomes for youth and families in Bayview Hunters Point. We started with our backpack giveaway 13 years ago, giving up 5,000 backpacks a year. Went to the Ratclifss and asked for Bayview support to make that happen. They supported our event each and every year. When we had the literacy program, book fair that we do every year, again, Bayview has always generously provided their support. And one thing that's so critical about Bayview News is that they're the only ones that will tell you the truth. Struggles of political prisoners and have consistently given a voice. Mm-hmm. I'd like to now introduce Mac Gonzalez to say a few words.
Really, first of all, I didn't put the tie on for you. I actually have to go to a memorial in a little bit, but it's been a great honor to know you over the years, and I really appreciate everything that you've done, not only for the Bayview community, but for San Francisco. I've had occasion to run for political office, and I've had your support in, I think, nearly every race that I've been involved with. I've also published original pieces in the newspaper, and I appreciate having had an opportunity to make those pieces available to the public. The work that you have done on behalf of our city, exposing issues, particularly related to criminal justice community and the inequities there, so many of the inequities that face our citizenry as it relates to, landlord-tenant issues, et cetera. I mean, it's just been incredibly important, and I truly am respectful and honored that you've done that work and that I know you. hope that you will keep this thing going for as long as you can. It's an important voice, and I think that you will. Thank you.
I'd like to present this plaque on behalf of the San Francisco Public Defender's Office to the San Francisco Public Defender's Office. Congratulations to the Bayview News for 40 years as a journalistic vehicle for the truth. And then there's a quote by Malcolm X: "The media is the most powerful entity on earth. They have the power to make the innocent guilty and to make the guilty innocent, and that's power because they control the minds of the masses." And thank you so much for being there for the masses, Willie and Mary.
Madhubaile I'm, you know, I'm 74, I'm older than dirt. And I knew if I didn't make friends with these kids, I was going to be the lunch meat on the sandwich, because they were hungry. And hungry people are dangerous. So I wrote them a love poem, and I thought it was going to end there. I got off the bus about a month, not the bus, the bar, a month after I wrote the poem, downtown San Francisco, and this nice, cute little chubby Chinese girl ran up to me, threw her arms around, and said, "Grandma! Who is this crazy child?" She was not crazy. She knew the whole poem. I had given each one of those kids on the corner a copy of the poem. It wound up in every street newspaper. The kids from Youth Speaks were doing it and what have you. She knew the poem. It's in Spanglish. She knew the English word. She knew the Spanish word. She knew what every word meant, and she read it to me off the page, which I can't even do myself, word for word. And she said something to change my life, and I'm going to say it to you because I think we forgot. She said, "Thank you." Yeah. Nobody ever talks to us. Those kids became my protectors. I couldn't get out of the car with a loaf of bread without having 10 of these little gangsters run up to me to help me. All I did was write them a love poem. She said, "All you did was say, you know," I said, "I love them by saying this poem." So I tell you, you better read, these are our children. These are our children. Don't forget, they are children. It will not hurt you to say thank you to them for being children. And just say hello. You don't have to take them home. You can say hello. Miracles happen if you let them know that you still love them. So I'm going to do this poem. It's in Spanglish. It's in my book if you just happen to want one. I have a few with me. It's called Street Children of the Night, Palo Chiquitito de la Noche en Cualquier Lugar. And I think you'll get the message with Mongo underneath it. Black and brown children of the night, que ya no saben nada el caminito de la calle. Queridos morenitos, whose ideas of having fun got swallowed by the darkness. If I could, I said, if I could, I would wrap you in sunshine. I would hold you close and fold you in these arms and correct whatever's left of my child in you with lullabies. I would like to cover every inch of you with home cooked supper, steam and better than say about contents. I want to fill the hole that earth does. Take my hand and I'd swim defiantly through the fires of hell for you and with you through the movement and disrespect. I'm a hard-headed kind of lady and I just can't see myself giving up on you. Somos lo que somos, you and I, para nosotros, como todo lo que hay, we've been fused together by history. Bonito, los sueños robados, look, locked spiritually in the veins of our destiny, worship. Mis negritos, mis pequeños callejeros, los necesito. The truth is, I know I need you, y yo sin ti soy nada. And if I had a chance, I'd refuse to turn you loose to you, and so in love with yourself. That self-destruction would disintegrate under the pressure of your presence, and you were so sure of my love for you, and so sure the splendor we had become, and you had become, that even the sun would lay aside its arrogance just to get a chance to reflect the brilliance of your essence, and bask in the bold truth of your integrity, and deep, even la verdad real y yo sin ti no existe ni un sendero de la esperanza, si can they see you? I say, oh, say, can they see you? You, my beautiful wild lotus flowers. If I could, I'd bathe you in a sea of rose water. I'd convert your waves of pain into an ocean of pride and faith. Yo te pido, dame un chance. Please, please, please let me in. I try to do the very best I can, even as I have to work the dead and conjure up our ancestors of breath. I'm not too proud to act a fool. Get down on my knees and holler and scream and beg all the spirits of goodness to intervene to blow away the fog and dismay and distrust. Saw something in Cardo Lagrimas and dissipate the rage burning behind your eyes so together we can wash away the centuries of emasculating doubt and defeminizing lies and have a little fun and learn to play a brand new game called Demolishing Walls of Self-Hate. Children of the night. I want the stubbornness of my love to help you turn on all the lights inside your soul. I will not allow the streets of any city to steal you. You like a lotus blossoming in a night of queridita's alma de mi existencia. I will not be successful or polinga, make a fast food and happy meal of your dreams. Chiquito de la esquina. You are our holy wealth. You are the most beautiful part of me, and I'm not too proud to admit it, and I'm not about to let you go. I say I will not permit the hungry stupidity and greed to feed you in the streets without putting up a fight. Amorcito pedido de la us and massage your mind with a steady diet, just how important you are. Make sure you know you're too damn important that the world just throw you away. It's my job to remind you on a daily basis this crazy old lady is here to say, I'm still here. I say, I'm still here. I'm still here saying and praying and praying and saying and praying 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 and praying. Let me end. I'm talking to you. Can you even hear me? It's our tomorrow that you're throwing away. I'm still waiting. A stubborn old lady with a heart full of love, standing in the shadows and waiting on who you could be, waiting for you to finally see me, waiting to wrap you in a blanket of sunshine, to wrap you in a blanket of sunshine, to wrap you in a blanket of sunshine.
Hear them singing that sounds like almost every building. The sheep out of the ground, you walk on it.
Folsom, they'll always be here. They refuse to disappear. Nothing can stop it. Gentrified can't block it. Same folks that dance in the blues, singing to the mambo session and back in the California hotel. They're at the door, so he's locked up. Blues will switch Jimmy and the Fifth Amendment. The same people in the children are bringing in the news. Queen Ida came 2 steps out the violin in the Zydeco parade. And Chicka Pie DeSanto and John the Hook will never grow old. Still right on top of all Tony Poland, Lady Beyonce, Jesse James, Easy Scott, Al Vaughn, Sister Monica, Bobby Webber, Gwen Avery, Little Frankie Lee, Billy Dunn, Wally Trash, Big Carol, Willie G, Frankie Kelly, Johnny Carter, Ronnie Stewart, Ethan Carolina, all stars, Mr. DeMar, Mr. Air. And just keep on coming and 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 nobody can stop it. Those other folks that keep their big heads stuck way up in the clouds, so it all comes back down to earth. The prize is ours and it's our jewel and it's still coming down. Old Town Blues. So we can play the blues for us.
Yeah!
Newspaper. At that time it was called the New BayView. in 1976. Straight from Hunter's Point, somebody that is proudly involved in the Justice for Mario Woods campaign, Mr. Mohammed al-Kareem.
The Ratcliffs were keeping this paper going. When we started the paper, until we couldn't do it anymore. But I'd like to have Mr. Ratcliff come out here. I want to tell him something, what the publisher, the printer told me. If he could come down, I want somebody to take my picture. But while he's on his way down here, there was something I never did tell J.R. The people who printed our paper, Mr. Alonzo Printing Company, was the pressman who printed the Black Panther newspaper on 16th Street. It's a coincidence that he told me, this is for the record, that the FBI office was across the street. And they could see the printing press from their office. And every week that the Black Panther newspaper was printed, they were first there before they picked up the paper. They got their copies every week. Mm. And he was saying when he first saw the paper, he said, wow, you guys are getting kind of rattled.
If you can help your little brother and sister that's at the disadvantage, kick to the curb. That's what it's all about. And we need to get involved with Mario Woods. Yeah. Justice for Mario Woods. Yeah. Justice for Alan Anto, Ken Harding, and all the other brothers and sisters that got killed in San Francisco and the country.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, I certainly want to thank my friend here for starting the paper. How many people have started the paper? And he stuck with it for a long time. And I'm quite proud of him that he could have got $10,000 for a paper, but we got it for $2,000. Because he cared, he said, well, I know what they'll do with it. The people that's offering this money, I know what they'll do with it.
Right.
So he chose us. I appreciate that, and I got high respect for this man. All right, thank you.
Right.
and royal blue.
Just can't seem to fix you. The demons raging war inside of you. A memorial of ones long gone, lost their life far too young, because all they really cared about was where he came from. Half inch, quarter inch, cut off sleeves, let his strings hang loosely. Look him fly during carnival. Unraveling the pieces, then putting it back together again. That's what creative minds do. Tighten the seam, fold neatly the creases. I look so good with you. Uplifting self-esteem with ease. Press, no stress. Revealing things I kept hidden inside. Man, there's a whole lot of room in here. Sometimes I just want to take it off. Topless, clothesless, leaving you speechless, nothing less. You feel so good on me. I want you all to myself. Black History Month, I believe, should be every month. Congratulations, happy 40th anniversary to y'all. This is called Black Beauty because you are so beautiful. Black beauty, everywhere I see it, I hear it, I can taste it. My five senses are taking chances with it, dancing to its rhythm. I just can't help it. I like what I see. I like what I feel when I'm next to it. It's exciting, and I can't get enough of it. So many want it and hate it at the same time, but it can be so confusing. I promise to not get stuck in your ignorance, but instead bathe in your beauty. Run my fingers through your woolen hair. Push my nose in it and take a deep breath. Breathing
in the new Bayview newspaper, and he was in the Bayview before the Ratclifss even became the owner. He also has worked with the San Francisco Black Film Festival and worked with a number of other organizations, LA Hits, and has been a publicist in the area. He still does stuff with the Bayview newspaper occasionally, a lot of times on movies and film festivals. That's Shot Tommy and Farrell.
Thank you.
Next, we have Apollonia Jordan. Apollonia is somebody who grew up in the Bayview newspaper. She grew up in the Bayview neighborhood, but also grew up with the newspaper. She was somebody that was a teenager when she became a writer. She is now a mother. She is now in college at San Francisco State and coming back to the Bayview newspaper to start to do more.
Thank you. It's an honor to be here.
Next, we have a veteran writer, Ms. Rochelle Metcalf, who was coming to us from the Sun Reporter. She does a lot of writing on what's going on 3rd Street and black business. Last but not least, right here on the right, or the right of the panel, we have Davey D, hip-hop journalist. Many of you know him from KPMA, Hard Knock Radio, DaveyD.com. Activist in the community, media warrior for a long time. So let's just start it off real quick with a two-minute thing. Can each of you tell the people, how did you become involved with the Bayview newspaper and why did you become involved?
Elated to be part of it. Okay, I went into the office one day and I had a conversation with Mary and Willie. I already had a degree in communications, emphasis in film. And my view was that I really didn't see where the black filmmakers and other filmmakers of consciousness were getting the publicity that they really needed. So I kind of sidetracked from making film to doing PR and marketing or entertainment news about film. And thank goodness for Willie and Mary, they gave me a chance to do that. So, again, even though I had a formal education from a recognized institution, I learned more at that newspaper than I did there. And I really am grateful for Willie and Mary giving me a shot. So, I'll be quiet now.
Jersey newspaper. I began writing when I was about 17 years old. And what got me to writing was really just wanting to have a youthful voice in the newspaper. We would often see the paper at our doorstep and wouldn't really check the paper out. And I also got involved with the newspaper through a youth movement program. It was actually an internship that I did for the newspaper and started writing about my experience in the foster care system as well as some issues as a young youth growing up in the hood.
All right, Michelle Metcalf. I'm sure many have read my columns through the years. I heard that. And I wrote a lot about social activities and other events. But Mary asked me to join the paper because they wanted to get a little social edge into the paper about Third Street and whatever else I may would want to write about. So I said, hey, that'd be cool. And as you know, Third Street, we need a lot of publicity to get the street moving. And I have a problem because we don't have black business. Everybody else is coming in. And as you know, Third Street now goes a long way, all the way down to the African-American cultural, it's not the cultural center, the diaspora. Down there on Third, near Mission, right, Moab, right. And so she sort of gives me the free flow to write what I want, and it's, you know, I write about the Giants and, you know, sports and other than that. But I've always, and I don't want to take too long, but I've always admired the Ratcliffs, especially Willie Ratcliff, because he reminds me of the fight that Dr. Carlton Goodland exercised. How many of you knew Dr. Goodland? Yeah. He ran that paper, and he didn't take any stuff. That's the way Willie is. So I appreciate being part of the family.
Yeah, all right.
My name is David D. I first really recall getting introduced to the Bayview through Lee Hubbard when he was writing, and what I think caught my attention, because I had already been writing, was seeing a newspaper that was doing this intersection between politics, social justice, and hip-hop, in other words, bringing a cultural bent to it that made it relatable. And so, you know, I think Lee had interviewed me for a couple of articles, and so naturally that's how I started reading it, and then because I was already writing, they would run some of my articles in the paper, which was also good in the sense that here you had a professional-looking type of publication where you're writing, which was at that time online, or every once in a while in a magazine, but now there was a consistent place that it could be at, unwatered down, undiluted, and just really, you know, able to say what you needed to say without being compromised. So that's really my introduction to the Bayview, and I'm proud of your 40 years, and it's good that this is a consistent entity that we have, probably one of the few that is left here in the Bay Area that hasn't really been compromised. So props for that.
Wanda Sevier, and I've been writing for the paper, hi Diana, for I think longer than most, I think about 20 years, is that right, Mary? Yeah, and what I like about the Bayview is that there's a certain freedom, uncensored freedom of expression, as long as it's revolutionary, as Willie said. So I had to, you know, sort of make sure that, and what I believe is revolutionary is art and politics that have a concrete manifestation in the community. So we're not just writing, we're not just philosophizing or presenting a particular perspective without some kind of action connected to it that's liberating and for the people. And I I don't remember how I met Mary Willie, but I do remember when I was working on my master's degree, I found out that Willie was from a black town. And I interviewed him for my master's, one of my first class on oral history. And we talked about his the founder of that town. And that, you know, and the black people that came from Africa and had African ways in Texas. And it was just really, really wonderful. But the reason why I ended up sort of stop writing for all the other papers because I was looking for a place where I could have guaranteed publishing. I said, well, if I write it, will you run it? And so when I was writing for the San Francisco Sun Reporter, it was, well, we have space, we'll run it. And when I was writing for the Oakland Post at that time, under Ms. Berkeley, it was like, well, if we have time, we'll run it. But Mary said, if you write it, we'll run it. Mm-hmm. And so... but it takes a lot of work covering things. I mean, you don't want to just, like, go put it in your... It's not vanity writing. You want to have an audience. So it's been really, really great. In lieu of financial... we used to get paid, and I haven't gotten paid for a while, but we get these great titles. A lot of, like, art and editors. Doesn't that sound fabulous? And Willie and Rat and Mary are like family. You know, they publish out of their kitchen. You know, their dining room is where they lay out the paper. It's just, you know, 24/7, that's their life. And, you know, you can't help but sort of be pulled in a movement like this. San Francisco BayView is actually a movement. And I'm really, really happy to be a part of it.
Last question that I'm going to ask before we turn it over to the floor. Me, I've been writing for the paper for about 16 years, and I've learned so much from artists that we've had in the paper, but also from campaigns. We've covered Haiti, we've covered the Congo, we've covered Rwanda constantly, we cover homelessness, we cover police terrorism, we cover political prisoners, we cover prisoner issues. And these are just some of the regular beats. But then we also cover local artists and national and international artists. For all of the panelists, what do you think the most important aspect of the Bayview is for you and your constituents? Let's start with David.
I was just thinking, you know, one of the things that I think we may not fully appreciate is that Bayview has been kind of like a historic document for us, meaning that you were talking about the artists. You know, over the years, you in particular, J.R., have interviewed a lot.
By other moment, I just want to say that I write an inspirational column for the Western Edition, and it's called Midget's Corner. Please read it, and now I'm writing a column on aging, because I'll be turning 80.
Wow. I'm very emotional standing here. Wonder. This wonder. All I can say is this wonder. You are the one who started me writing here in San Francisco. Mm. I would read your column all the time. And I was sitting in a Fillmore cafe, and I said, I want to write. And a newspaper fell on the floor, and I asked the young person, who does the editing of this paper? And he told me, and the editor was going out the door, and I got up and I ran out the door, and I said to the editor, I would like to write a piece. Send it to me, and I did. 9 years, August 26th, I've been writing that column. Mm. Salary? No, it ain't happening. The press packet is that.
Hello, family. My name is Mawate. My mother called me Fred Jr. I heard a lot of positive things here today. I want to commend the owners of the paper. I was in prison for quite a long time, and they sent papers free into that dark place, and there was light from the baby. I also heard a lot of positive things about collective unity, and I support our community supporting ourselves. We could all put in a dollar a month, $5 a month, $1 a day, and we can support the Bayview paper. We can also support getting our brothers and sisters from up under these bridges. We need to stand up. You know, the first 100,000 miles all begin with that first step, and that step begins with us. We are the directors, the writers, and the authors of our script, and it's what we want, and it's how bad we want it. And if we want it bad enough, we'll start today. So somebody said that they needed help in this community. Why are we not trying to help each other? Why are we going to put a blindfold over our eyes and turn like ain't nothing happened? They take in the community here, and why are we not standing up? Okay, so the question is on you to ask yourself when you leave here, what are you going to do? We ought to have some type of vehicle where we could hopefully the Bayview set up a like a trust fund for us to be able to send that money into that paper for that day of need, to change some of the circumstances that are going on in our community. And I like to say, because I was a past alcoholic, that let's stay away from drugs and alcohol and smoking cigarettes. Let's stay away from that. Send that money into Bayview.
Everybody keeps hitting on a little bit is that we are in financial danger as the Bayview newspaper. So people that are interested in donating a little bit or a lot, you know, because a lot will go farther than a little bit. If you, whatever you can donate, we'll accept it. But please talk to Willie and Mary Ratcliff when this is over, because we're in a dire situation right now with this next edition published. And also, I just want to remind people, we have food and cake after, and we also have Stony Creation about to perform. I see that we have two more people. We'll end it after that, or three more people. We'll end it after that, and then let's party. Mr. Francisco.
My friends, I'm here to pay my respects to Willie and Mary. And I've been involved with the Bayview for a long time. What I try to do is, when I represent, is take photographs. So I have thousands and thousands of photographs of all the works on the environmental front, on the home front, transportation. And you need a newspaper. And a newspaper does justice to the community. But I also believe that young people, anybody who has education, should use the digital format to express themselves. So, when they murdered Oscar Grant, I was one of the first to write for indie media, but also reported in the Bayview and on my website. And the same thing happened when Mario Woods was killed. We do not have people who can give the right information quickly. So I've heard a lot today, and of course I'll report on what I heard, just like I normally do. And so once again, Willie and Mary, I thank you very much, and I encourage the young people here and the elders who I see from KFU and other organizations to help the young people so that we can represent. Thank you very much.
Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to take this. We said we're going to take these next two people. And we're going to have a party so you can speak to everybody else, because we are on a time restriction and we also have people scheduled to perform. So we don't want to mess any of that up. So we have two more people left.
so I'm now living in Texas. My name is D Minor. I'm lived only by D Minor. I helped put Keith Jackson on the school board, and I'm so honored. Mary and I are Facebook friends, and someone sent me a notice saying this event was going on, and I said, there's no way that I cannot be there. So in 3 days or 4 days, and my cousin's visiting me, she's traveling with me today, I said, we're going. Mary and Willie are icons. They're real. I hold great respect for them. And believe me, it was no way that I was not going to miss this. When she saw me, she said, are you really here? I said, yes, I am. You know, they're wonderful. They're about the truth.
Yeah.
As raw as it may get, I know Kareem. I remember when Kareem hadn't sold the paper. I remember when he sold it. I was there in Mary's some little room when they was putting together the Bayview, and they had just purchased the paper. So I'm old school here, and I work for the school district. My name again is D Minor, and I'm so honored, and it's so wonderful to see everyone turn out. I wouldn't have missed it for nothing in the world. You know, and I'm glad, and again, kudos to you, and I'm so glad to see the power of the people, and I come here, she has on board the community people that's here. I love it, and thank you.
I'm going to make this really fast. It's an honor to be here. I congratulate everybody on the 40th, and I've heard many times how people have left San Francisco, and that's why I want to make this very important announcement. This Tuesday, February 23rd, on the steps of City Hall, a group of us getting together to make sure there's affordable housing in the new projects and developments that are being done in the Tenderloin and all over the city. That's at noon, and hopefully you can make it, but also at 3 o'clock in room 250 in City Hall, the Board of Supervisors, one of them you've seen here today, are going to listen to us. So the more voices that are heard, the more chance that we will have affordable housing in the city. And I thank you for your time and good work. Really, thank you.
Some last words that they would like to wish the 40th anniversary of the Bayview. But last but not least, two things I wanted to acknowledge about the Bayview newspaper. One, we see all of what's happening in Ferguson. We saw what happened in New York. We saw what happened in San Francisco. We saw what happened in Oakland with Oscar Grant. The Bayview newspaper was a big, huge part of that. Oscar Grant's movement, which the Bayview held like its own baby, was the beginning of this anti-police terrorism movement. So clap it up for yourselves, for many activists and writers. First anniversary of the assassination of Malcolm X today. And the Bayview was also very prominent in recognizing Malcolm Shabazz, his grandson, who was murdered in 2013, frequented the area a lot, did a lot of work in California and other places, but he was a big part of the Bayview newspaper. So out of respect for the Shabazz family, y'all clap it up again.
Last words.
First of all, and not just because you are hustling it around and bringing it everywhere, but also, you know, I think it's commendable that you learned how to actually put a paper together as well. So that wealth has been passed down to another generation, so I think that's good as well, and we should acknowledge that, because a lot of places you don't got that sort of passing of the baton in mentorship. I would just say that we shouldn't take these institutions for granted. Just this year alone, if you think about all the people that have passed, you know, from,
Francis,
thank you. I couldn't get the name out. Francis Cress Welding on down. We've lost some institutions, you know, in wisdom and strength and what have you. We're celebrating our 50th anniversary, and we see the efforts to try to tamp down what the Panthers really mean. Yeah.
you know, for a generation or several generations of people. So I think not only should we have that support if we're able to financially, but it's also community support. It's the Bayview and reference that you hold up as much as you might CNN or some other institution when we're talking. You know, a lot of people say, well, you have a link, or we read about it on Fox. We hold that up as that is that is if that's the authority. Do we hold the Bayview with the same sort of love and care and use that as an authority? Is that making sense what I'm saying? Yeah. So I just want to make sure that we kind of keep that in mind, because that's really what's going to take that legacy of the Bayview to the next level, that we hold it up as our own, you know, document and our own paper of record, you know, that's been here for 40 years. So congratulations on that from the bottom of my heart.
Ashe. Say Ashe.
Ashe.
Ashe. Ashe. Are we going to continue another 40 years?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you going to help?
Yes.
With your money?
Yes.
We need money.
Okay.
Otherwise, March might be the last issue.
Oh.
Might be the last issue. Would you want that?
No.
Okay. Get your checkbooks or call Mary and let's say, hey, I want to be a part of donating to this paper. Otherwise, we don't have a paper that speaks for us. We got all the political bourgeois news, and you know what papers I'm talking about. But they're not covering the people. The Bayview is about the people. You know, the people, all of you, all of you. So God bless you, and I look to see you again.
I just wanted to say thank you to Mary and Willie for supporting me and supporting me as a writer throughout these years. I'm very thankful. Thank you to everyone who reads my articles. And look out for my novel. I'm working on a novel coming out this year, so look out for that, pre-sales. And free Malia.
Well, thank you and congratulations, Willie and Mary, for 40 wonderful years, and to Kareem for starting us on this journey. And I just wanted to let everyone know that today is also a birthday of a woman who definitely is a cultural warrior, and that's Nina Simone. Yeah. And in the spirit of Stanley Nelson, the director of Black Panther, Vanguard of the Revolution, his first film, Soldiers Without Swords, looking at Black press, and at that particular time, Abe Montague was alive, and we had parties with Stanley and the African American Art and Culture Complex, and the San Francisco International Film Festival was more in the community at that time, and so Black folks were really aware of how important it is to have a vehicle for their voice, because the Black press, the real Black press, gets it right in a way that the San Francisco Bayview is a part of a large history and a powerful legacy, began by, you know, mavericks like Ida B. Wells Barnett, who not only published her paper, Got Ran Out of Mississippi, but she also sort of monitored police brutality, and at that time they were using nooses, right? And you see what happened to Willie's business, nooses at the airport. So like the nooses and the handguns and the drugs and all that is still happening. And how do we know those things? It's through documenting them, through getting the word out, through the San Francisco Bayview and other vehicles that are similar throughout the country. So it's really, really important. And I want to say, you know, power to the people, all power to the people, and power to the Black press. Yes.
Well, again, big, big ups to Willie and Mary, because we all know what they go through to put on the paper. And you know what, big ups to everybody here, because everybody here is definitely conscious just to be here, you know? Because the Bayview is go to. So big ups, and I also want to give a shout out to the San Francisco Black Film Festival, which you have helped out immensely, and also the Oakland International Film Festival, which you also helped out immensely. So those are coming up. JR, I know you worked on this diligently, man. Big ups to you too, Cam. Right on. Thank you.
Clap it up again for our illustrious panel. As well as the ones who are making this panel, like I said, Adam Kumar did set up the power for the baby in this crowd. Adam Kumar, if you can raise your hand. You guys may know some of his pictures. But there are others. But before we wrap it up, can I bring our last performer, the youngest one? Actually, let's clear this up a little bit. Can we get everybody raised up? Because I got to bring her up. Al, can you help me get these chairs? Young people, we fight for our community. No holds barred. That's one of the first things. One of the second things is we profile talent. And Miss Stoney Creation is a teenager. She's a conscious rap artist. A lot of the older people say, I don't see conscious rap. Well, that's why we bring it to you at the 40th anniversary of the BayView, so you can see it live up close and personal. And not just an older rapper, but a very young, up-and-coming rapper who's just starting out doing her thing, and she's good at it. She makes her own music. Her mom is her momager, like Beyonce and them. Y'all clap it up for Smith Stone Creation.
How's everybody doing? I'm so honored to be here to really actually be able to share my life, a true activist, artist, actually. And to be representing youth, you know, because, like, this is important. We are the future. I'm here to really just bring pure truth, cosmic energy, and purity to the room, the community, and for everybody, because this is what I'm here for. This is my mission. So I just want to bring y'all on my journey of, you know, the cosmic life and music that I bring and create.
First focus,